Welcome back. In the previous video, we saw interconversion from decimal to binary and binary to decimal. In this video, we will focus upon converting decimal number systems into octal and octal to decimal. We already know that the base used in octal number system is 8, that is base 8. So in binary, and that means when we converted decimal to binary, what we did is we divided the decimal number with 2. But in case of octal, what we will do is we will divide the decimal number by 8. Suppose we have a decimal number 670 and we want to convert it into octal. So we start off by dividing 670 with 8. So what we get is 670 divided by 8 is equal to 83 as quotient and 6 as remainder. Now we divide this 83 with 8. We get 10 as quotient, 3 as remainder. Now we divide 10 with 8 to get 1 as quotient and 2 as remainder. Now 1 divided by 8 will obviously give 1 as remainder. The bottommost number will be placed at the left hand side, and then we move on to the top. So the bottommost number over here is 1, so we place it in the leftmost side. Next is 2, so we place 1, we place 2 adjacent to 1, then is 3, and then 6. The octal equivalent of 670 decimal is 1236. Let us take a look at one more example. Over here, we have a decimal number, that is 41.6875. We divide this integer part by 8. So we get 8 divided by 5. That means 40. And obviously the remainder is 1. So the equivalent octal of 41 is 51, counting from bottom to top. So we write it as 51. Now, in case of decimal to binary, what we did for the fractional or the decimal part was that we multiplied it with 2 until we got a zero, a perfect zero at the end. In this case also, we'll do the same thing, but that multiplication with 2 will be replaced by multiplication with 8. So basically, we multiply this decimal part by 8. So 0.6875 multiplied by 8 gives 5.5. Now, we take only this particular decimal part, the part that is after the point or the decimal point. So we have 0.5 multiplied by 8. So 0.5 multiplied by 8 gives 4.0. Now, as because we have obtained a perfect zero after the decimal point, we do not proceed any further. But same as what I told previously in case of binary, if you do not get a perfect zero, then just make 5 to 6 multiplications with 8 and then terminate the process. So after performing this multiplication with 8, what we get is 5.4. Obviously, as because this part was after the decimal point, we will consider it top to bottom. That means 5 will come first and then will come the 4. Therefore, we get the entire octal number for the decimal number, which was 41.6875. And the octal number is 51.54. Let us take a look at one more example. We have 10.25 in decimal number system and we want to convert it to octal number system. So first of all, we'll convert this integer part into octal. So obviously, if you divide 10 by 8, then you get, say suppose over here 41 is replaced by, let me take the pointer. Say suppose this 41 is replaced by a 10. So if you divide it by 8, then you get 1 as the quotient and 2 as the remainder. 10 in decimal number system is equivalent to 12 in octal. Now we are interested to find the octal equivalent of this 0.25 or the fractional part. So 0.25 into 8, it directly gives you a 2.00. So we do not need to proceed any further and the process gets terminated over here itself. So the equivalent octal number of 0.25 is 2, and hence we get the entire number as 10.25 decimal is equal to 12.2 octal. Now let us see how to convert octal into decimal. So when we converted binary numbers into decimal, what we did was we raised 2 to the power of the positional weights. So over here, everything will remain the same, just that the 2 that we used in binary will be replaced by 8, that is the base of octal numbers. So let's see how. Suppose we have 5746 octal and we want to convert it into decimal. So what we do is, positional weight of 6 is 0. So we have 6 into 8 to the power 0. Positional weight of 4 is 1. So 4 into 8 to the power 1. Similarly, 7 into 8 square and 5 into 8 cube. So upon computing, that gives 5 into 1, 512, 7 into 64, 4 into 8 and 6 into 1. So the values are right on the screen. And upon addition, the final value that we get is 3046. Therefore, 5746 in octal is equivalent to 3046 in decimal. Let us take a look at one more example. In this case, we have a decimal point. So the number is 6.1 and we want to convert it into decimal. Now the positional weight of the 6 is 0. So we write a 0 over here. And positional weight of this 1, that means it is right after the decimal point. Therefore, the weight of this 1 will be minus 1, the positional weight. So we raise 8 to the power of minus 1. Now 8 to the power of minus 1 is nothing but 1 by 8. So that is what we have written over here. So ultimately we get 6 into 8 to the power 0 plus 1 into 1 by 8. Upon performing this computation, we get 6 plus 0.125, which is 6.125. Thus, the decimal equivalent of 6.1 in octal is 6.125. In this example, we have 51.54 in octal. So, positional weight of this 1 is 0 and 5 is 1. So, we write 5 into 8 to the power 1 plus 1 into 8 to the power 0. And over here, we have the positional weight of 5 as minus 1 and 4 as minus 2. So we will get 5 into 8 to the power minus 1, which means 5 into 1 by 8 plus 5 into 8 to the power minus 2, which is nothing but 5 into 1 by 8 square. Upon calculating the values, we have 40 plus 0.625 plus 0.078125. If we sum it up, we get 40.703125. So this number is the decimal equivalent of 51.54 octal, obviously. Now we have 12.2 octal and we want to convert it into decimal. So we will write 1 into 8 to the power 1 plus 2 into 8 to the power 0, because their positional weights are 0 and 1 respectively. And for this decimal part, we write 2 into 8 to the power minus 1. This is actually what I was telling you earlier over here. This 1 by 8 is nothing but 8 to the power minus 1. So upon calculating these values, we get 8 plus 2 plus 0.25, which is nothing but 10.25. Therefore, the decimal equivalent is 10.25 for the octal number 12.2. That is all for this video. Thank you.